Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 90 of Java for Tester series, that is object class arrays. So before I explain what exactly is this object class and how it can be used with arrays, let me first practically demonstrate a problem statement. Okay, I will first show you the problem statement practically, guys. Then I will show you how this object class arrays are going to help in this case. For example, guys. Okay, for example, I declare a array, an integer array. Okay, I declare a variable with integer array and I assign some integer literals here. Let's say 9, 5, 4, okay, 8, etc. I will not get any errors because I am assigning the integer literals to the variable which is declared with integer array. Since this variable is declared with integer array, I can assign multiple integer literals. That's possible. What if I try to assign something like not only integer literals, I'll try to assign different values, like 9 is an integer literal. So, and I will try to assign some 88L. Okay. And this is a long literal, guys. Okay. This 9 is an integer literal, which I can easily assign to the variable A, which is declared with integer array. But here I am trying to assign long literal. Okay. Long literal and floating point literal like 3.56F. Okay, double literal like 1.23 is a double literal. Then Boolean literal, character literal, string literal. Okay, any other literals left, guys? Long, float, character, Boolean, characters. Like this, different types of literals I am trying to assign here. Okay, so the variable which is declared with integer array, I am trying to assign different literal types. Is it possible, guys? It's not possible because the variable is declared with integer array and you are trying to assign some different type of literals which are not supported. Okay, only few literals are supported but remaining are not supported. What if I make it like boolean array? Okay, only this boolean literals will be supported, guys. Remaining literals will not be supported. That's the problem. But is there any way where into this single variable, okay, into the single variable I want to assign these different type of literal values? Okay, it's not possible, right? If I declare this with int, few literals are not accepted. Few literals are accepted, few are not accepted. If I make them double, few are accepted. Okay, most of the literals are accepted, and you see this boolean literal and string literals are not accepted. If I make it character array, you see only few literals are accepted and remaining literals are not getting accepted. Like that, guys, all the literals, okay, if I make it float, like this, okay, few are accepted, few are not accepted. So the problem here is, okay, that the problem here is we can assign only one type of literals to the one type of declared arrays, okay, data type. Based on the data type array, based on the data type of the array, we can assign the literals, but we cannot assign different type of literals to the same variable. Okay, this is a problem statement. The problem statement is, if you try to assign, okay, multiple values of different data types, literal types, okay, if you try to assign multiple values of different literal types to the same variable, okay, that is not possible if you declare this variable with different data types like int, long, float and all. Okay, that is not the solution. So what is the solution, guys? How to solve this problem? How to assign different type of literals to the same variable? Is it possible? Yes, guys, it's possible. That is possible with the help of the object class array. So simple, guys. Instead of giving here int, double, float, okay, long, boolean, char, something like that, if I give something like object here, you see all the errors got resolved. The moment I declared this variable with object array, okay, the moment I declared this variable A with object array, all the literals are able to be, okay, we are able to assign all the different type of literals, integer literals, long literals, floating point literals, double literals, boolean, character, okay, string literals to the same variable. This is getting possible because I declared this variable with object array. How can it be possible, guys? How can it be possible? How can we be able to assign different type of literal types to the same variable? How this object class array is able to solve this problem? Let's find it out. Okay, the reason here is object class is the parent class of all the classes in Java, guys. Okay, and is the root class of Java. Object class is the parent class of all the classes in Java and is the root class of the and the root class are in Java, guys. So let me show you how that happens. Okay, if I Google search for something like Java 8 API, just Google search for Java 8 API, guys, and you will get this link, docs.oracle.com Java SE8 docs API kind of link you will get. Click on that. It will take you to the API page of that Java API. Just on the left side, you can see there are different classes here, guys. Select any class. Let's say I will select this class, abstract border class. When I selected that class, what is the parent of this abstract border, guys? The parent of this abstract border class is object class. Object class is a parent. So what if I go to another way, other place, like a different, okay? Different array. Here also atomic boolean, some classes there in Java library API, and its parent is also object. Whatever the class you take, guys, okay, let's go to another different class, okay, and try to see what is the parent class of that. Serial array is also having the object class. The simple formatter, is having the parent class as formatter, and this formatter is having the parent as object. So on the top, object is there, okay. Object looks like the root class, guys. What if I click on this object, guys? Does object have any parent class? Let's find it out. Here you see, object doesn't have any parent class, guys. Object is the main one. Object is parent of all the other classes in Java, guys. It's a root class, you can say. Class object. Object is a class in Java, guys, and is the root of the class hierarchy. All the classes in Java, this library or API, are the children of this object class. The children or grandchildren of this object class. Okay, every class has object as a super class. The parent class or super class means it's a grandparent or parent, something like that. Okay, all objects including arrays implement the methods of this class. So whatever the methods are that are there in this object class, okay, can be implemented by all the remaining classes in Java. So guys, since object class is the parent or super class of all the classes in Java and is the root class of the Java, okay, that's the reason, guys, we can assign any type of data into the variable which is declared as object arrays. That's the trick behind that, guys. Okay, here I have mentioned, instead of the data type, I mentioned the object class, which is making different type of literals to be assigned to the variable. Okay, because I mentioned here, instead of the data type, when I mentioned the object class beside this array, I was able to assign different type of literals to the same variable, because object class is the object is a class in Java, guys, predefined class in Java, and is a root class or super class of all the other classes in Java, guys. Okay, it's a root class and super class of all the classes in Java, and just because of this reason, we can assign different type of literals to the same variable which is declared with this object array, object class array data type. Okay, object class array type, you can say. So guys, so now you understood what exactly are these object class arrays. Okay, using this object class arrays, if you, instead of providing the data type arrays like int, float array, or character array or boolean array, if you give object class array, then you can assign different type of literals into the same variable. Okay, so that is the purpose of the object class arrays. So that's it, guys. In the next video session, I will explain the next topic, that is disadvantage of arrays. So what is the disadvantage of arrays? Okay, arrays has a lot of capabilities, as I have explained as part of the previous videos and this current video, but it also has a disadvantage, guys, that I'm going to explain as part of the next video session. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.